we have nominations.
Board members of the Institute of Corporate Governance of Uganda, including consultants, have today held a news briefing where they expressed disappointment over the poor participation of government bodies in the upcoming Corporate Governance Awards. Despite the repeated calls, only 19 nominees have turned up out of the expected 1,000 nominees. With the mission to promote excellence in corporate governance principles and practice, the awards were intended to check on accountability, excellence, integrity, responsibility, and transparency of government bodies. The president of the institute, Joseph Badidawa, maintained that it was a must for every organization to participate, but the low turnout speaks a lot about the performance of most organizations in the country.
We have been receiving money from the exchequer. If there are NGOs, they have been receiving money from donors, but they have to manage those funds appropriately for the benefit of those that are intended to receive the services. The only way for us to know how they have done that is to be transparent and show us that they have done a good job.
So we are somehow disappointed because at this rate, with only 5 days to go, having this limited small number is so much telling of the state of corporate governance in the country, because we would ideally expect most of the institutions per category, for example, financial institutions, out of the 24 tier 1 institutions, we would expect all of them by now to have nominated themselves. However, we have only got 6.
Poorly managed bodies have not only cost government, but also seen many businesses falling short after their launch. During the awards, the panel of judges, which is composed of experts in corporate governance, is expected to give deeper insights into what a company board is supposed to be.
Because when somebody fails, I think what you're going to feel it is, if somebody is not sure if they are going to win, they may not participate. We encourage those ones to participate, because by participating, they'll get an opportunity to streamline their corporate governance structures.
As you understand that it is first of its kind, it's going to be the first time. And celebrating this beautiful concept, and yet this particular excellence in corporate governance has not been thought about.
The awards, set for 17th of May 2018, will see the best corporate governance practitioners celebrated. This report is by Joliet Namoya for Urban TV.